Second pinion actuator anodized aluminum limit switch installation. The limit switch assembles to an aluminum rack and pinion actuator with the use of a stainless steel bracket. The bracket is mounted to the bottom of the limit switch and the top of the actuator. Assemble the flat side of the bracket to the bottom of the limit switch using 4 bolts and lock washers. Hand tighten the bolts only. Leaving or removing the indicator is optional. Thread 4 set screws into the interface at the top of the actuator mounting pad. Place the limit switch and bracket on top of the actuator so that the conduit entry on the switch box is on the same side as the solenoid. The shaft will slide into the slot on the pinion. Place 4 flat washers, 4 lock washers, and 4 nuts onto the set screws of the actuator. Tighten the 4 nuts on the actuator and the 4 bolts under the limit switch. Add the air supply to test rotation. To adjust the position of the indicator in the window, loosen the 4 upper screws and rotate the beacon. After adjustment, retighten the screws. Back out the captive cover bolts on the limit switch box. Carefully lift off the cover of the limit switch. Set the cams inside the limit switch box so that they depress the micro switches. Push down on the cam so it clears the splines, rotate, and release. When the valve is closed, the red cam should depress the upper switch. Open the valve to set the yellow open cam. To set the lower cam, lift away from the splines and rotate so that it depresses the lower micro switch. Close the valve to ensure that the red cam depresses the upper switch. The engaged cam color corresponds to the color in the window of the beacon. Make sure the gasket is completely in the groove of the switch body. Place the cover on carefully so the shaft goes into the square hole in the indicator. Tighten the 4 bolts on the limit switch cover. Cycle the valve. Rack and pinion actuator anodized aluminum limit switch installation.